recording our annual culture show. This year really was a wonderful experience for all of us, and we really hope it was for you guys as well.
We love you, man!
Okay, so we thank you guys for all coming. Oh, partnering as co-presidents for the first year raised many questions. People wonder how could Soojin and I, two people with different many accounts, lead an entire organization and executive board without clashing? Well, we knew that we shared a common passion for the Korean culture, which was reason enough to commit our senior years to share our love with the rest of BU campus.
Despite our contrasting personas, we worked together to unite as one with our common Korean root. There are many differences in the Korean-American culture and the Korean traditional culture, and we hope that Min and I working together will reflect this year's culture show theme, which is wedding clashes.
We're so proud of where KSA has gotten, and we really want to send a special thank you to our current and past e-board members, because without you guys, we wouldn't be here today. And so with that, we thank you guys so much for coming, and we really hope you guys will enjoy the show.
Let's go to the town, the sound, oh, let's go.
Andrew met in the summer of 2008. Andrew had been living in Korea since he was born and was attending culinary school in Gangnam, one of the most affluent cities in Korea. Kelly was in Korea for the first time in her life to take a summer course at Yonsei University. The two crossed paths in a cable car on their way up to the famous Namsan Tower, a national landmark in Seoul. At the top of the mountain, you can see a stunning view of the city. The two realized that although they grew up in different cultures, they had a lot in common. They both loved to travel and to try new things. They were both open-minded and optimistic. Although Andrew spoke in broken English, Kelly understood him and found him to be very charming. Over the next few months, Andrew took Kelly to all the fun places around Seoul. Their first rodeo was at Lotte World, the world's largest indoor amusement park. He would spend time in Hongdae, where college students like to hang out and sing at karaoke bars. Andrew also took Kelly to Insalong, streets rich in folk culture. They attended High Seoul Festival, where Kelly learned more about the Korean culture than she had ever known before. The more time they spent together, the more their feelings for each other grew. But after Kelly returned to the US, things became much harder for them. Kelly was finishing her studies in Boston, while Andrew remained in Korea. It was difficult to maintain a long-distance relationship, but they both persevered. In 2012, Andrew and his family moved to the United States, and he was offered a job at a famous restaurant in Boston. Their relationship continued to flourish, and on Valentine's Day of 2012, Andrew proposed to Kelly. She, of course, said yes.
Many pretty tradition girls there. Buddy, let's go!
Yeah, praise Ajumma!